Hey everyone, it's Neil with ChannelFireball.com, and here we have the green-black Gitrog Monster Madness sort of graveyard combo deck with Ghirapur Orrery that I wrote about. This is the exact list from my article, so you're going to get to see that today in a league. So we're going to get to play all five matches, so let's hop on over and get battling here. So we're on the play. This hand is okay, but not great, because I have a couple five drops. But I do have Key to the City and Prized Amalgam. So if I go turn two, key, discard Amalgam, untap, draw, key, I'm pretty likely to have a turn four Amalgam plus some other stuff. Plus I have Weaponcraft Enthusiast. So I think this hand is just on the border, but I am going to keep it. A couple other cards I also can like pitch if I draw Haunted Dead. So go ahead and do this. I think the best card in this deck is Noose Constrictor, just because it synergizes with pretty much everything. Gitrog Monster, Prized Amalgam, bringing that back. You know, it synergizes with your Voldaren Pariahs to just madness them on the cheap. So that's a card you often want to look for in your opening hand, but here I'm probably just not going to use keys since I have a third land. I'm just going to play Enthusiast next turn. Unsurprisingly, playing against blue-white. Pretty standard. Over there after Prairie Stream, I'm just going to untap here, though, as I was saying. Yeah, that one's not great. I will say that Pariah is really good in this matchup, so if we can resolve a Voldaren Pariah or an Eldritch Evolution, get that into play, you can sweep their board. It's pretty hard for them to get enough creatures to get around the Pariah. Here we're probably going to Reflector Managed, yeah. Whether or not hitting Enthusiast or Servo will be a little interesting. Yeah, that makes some sense. Right now I feel like we're definitely a bit behind, but my hand was a bit medium to start with, so it's certainly not the end of the world. As you can see, like, this is part of the reason why Constrictor is so good, although Reflector Mage obviously would bounce it here, but stopping Smuggler's Copter is a big part of what that card does, and you really don't mind blocking and discarding multiple cards to take down a copter from a post-block with a Constrictor. This is fine. I'm just going to discard this. We will untap. I am going to draw, and I'm going to leave Forest untapped. And maybe I want to leave Swamp untapped because of Haunted Dead, actually. It's a little bit close. And didn't really hit on either. Alright, well, what is our plan here? I guess my plan is to attack with a servo and chump with a Weaponcraft. I have two 5-drops in my hand, so if I just draw land, then we could do that. This card is much more a role player in this deck. It's nice because it does synergize with both Pariah and Eldritch Evolution, of which you have two copies of each. So it's pretty good, but it's not a card you really want to draw multiples of. You can see here I'm not really getting my graveyard engine going, so sort of just have to wait on that. Okay, so they just activated Copter with Reflector Mage. What this tells me is they're pretty likely to just, and they didn't play this, they're pretty likely to just have Spellqueller. My guess is they just drew Thraven Inspector, because why not just play it and attack otherwise if they already had Spellqueller? Or we're getting post-combat Gideon, but that would also have to be the draw, because could just play Gideon and make a token and attack. So that's my analysis of this situation. I don't really understand the discard Draven Inspector and have Gideon, because like I said, they probably just had to draw this, but I don't quite know how that works out math-wise. Alright, so I don't really need this extra Weaponcraft Enthusiast. I could try to draw a card so I hit another land drop, but I'm not really pressuring Gideon. But these also aren't really great there. I really want to find a Haunted Dead or a Scrap Heap Scrounger to bring back Prized Amalgam. So I think I'm still just going to discard. Okay, discard one of these. And untap. One of each. Oh, we are not drawing well this game. A little bit awkward. Could discard a card and tact Gideon with the servo. Yeah, maybe I should have done that. I think Orreries are still fine in this matchup. They're a bit worse on the draw. Sometimes you want to board them out. I don't really have time to draw with Key here, so I'm just going to untap and draw. And we drew a tap land. I'm just too far behind at this point to really get anywhere, but I guess we will play on. Didn't really want to discard an Orrery because then they know about it. I think I'm just going to discard. Taking three. I'm going to play the Weapon Craft. I think I just should play this first to see if it gets Spell Quellered. Though I'm also not really being an Avacyn here. So if it gets Spell Quellered, I just can't attack. I think I'm still just going to discard this, though. I could potentially win if I draw Pariah, so revealing that I have Orrery in my deck doesn't really matter that much. Like, I am taking a lot of damage, but it's not lethal. Although, actually, Pariah doesn't really work because Copter can get crewed off Avacyn, and then Avacyn just flips. So if I take enough damage here where a flipped Avacyn kills me, then we are in quite a lot of trouble. Also, this doesn't really work because I'm just gonna. If I don't block and I drew Pariah, then we die to flip. And this way it doesn't work anyways because I just don't have enough to flip a Pariah. So, yeah, we have lost this one, but that's okay. I think of the like normal matchups, Blue White is the hardest because they can interact with your plan while also applying a lot of pressure. Anyways, what I like here is I like bringing in these. I don't like evolutions. I do like the last Pariah. This just gets reflected, so I actually just don't like having Gitrog in my deck. And let's see, I like shaving an Orrery. I think it can still be good. But they have a lot of flash, so they can actually dump their hand and get around this and use it to their advantage. You don't want to draw too many of them. Can probably also probably get rid of either a Key or an Enthusiast. Enthusiast is okay because it can make life more awkward for Gideon. And I think bringing in the third Pariah means we want all the Enthusiasts still. I think I'm just going to cut a Key and board like this. We still have 8 discard outlets for Prize Amalgam. I could consider boarding in the island, but I normally when I board an island, I swap it for a swamp. Against aggro matchups, and I think here all the swamps are good because they trigger faster Pariahs off discards. So I'll do this. My other option also is going up to I don't really want to go up to 26 lands, though. That's an aggressive amount. Alright. So this hand has a lot of explosive potential here. We could potentially turn 3 Pariah. Looks like that's going to be what's happening. If I draw another land, I could also Enthusiast into... Yeah, Haunted Dead is a discard, though. This costs 5 to do that anyways. So just not that excited to do so. Could trade with the copter, but I don't think we want to. That's a bit annoying. We also have the option of just playing Enthusiast and threatening a Pariah flip. And they discarded Stasis Snare. Often when something like that gets discarded, it usually means they have a second one. Playing Pariah does help against Reflector Mage. But not a ton, because they can target the Mage, and if I flip this, they can still just animate... Well, they can't animate Copter that turn. And then I could just replay the Pariah, and then have Haunted Dead. So the question is, do I just untap an Enthusiast? My other option is pay and try to hit an untapped land for Haunted Dead, but it has to be a basic now that Thalia is in play. I think we just don't pay for key. I think we're doing okay as is. Would have been a basic, but that's fine. Evolving Wilds is especially bad versus Thalia. I'm just going to play Hissing Quagmire and an Enthusiast. Probably worth discarding the Haunted Dead to the key and paying. Lets me find more amalgams and kind of combo off that way. Which I think is better than spending mana on it, so... In step, just say go. Alright, let's go ahead and say okay, discard this. And I would like to draw. Yeah, that's not great. Stasis Snare that. So I could trade some things for Thalia here and lose my Pariah. Trade my whole board for Thalia. Actually, I guess I'm really trading this and these for Thalia, right? That's my option. Could also trade the Haunted Dead and keep one of these attacking, but Haunted Dead pressures Gideon better. And it's a 2-2. Also, doing this makes Reflector Mage way worse against me, because I get to save the Haunted Dead. So yeah, I think I'm actually just going to do this. Really, this is just a 2-for-2. It looks a lot worse because I had a lot more bodies in play, but it's really not that bad. So I'm going to discard my whole hand here. And I have a main phase hold because of Amalgam. Just, I guess, FYI. Alright, let's go ahead and Haunted Dead. And I think loot with the key as well. Pretty solid draw. just gonna pass here. Natural state the smuggler's copter. What's the clue? Because I could even just kill it right now. Like, I don't know what they can really do about it. I could wait till they crew, but then I get blown up by reflector, or I get blown up by spellqueller for no reason. Negate? Is that a card? I guess they technically could have negate. It is unlikely. There's almost no universe where they don't crack clue there, though. I could also blow up Stasis Snare instead. That's probably just way better, actually. Yeah, why don't I just do that? I completely was focusing on the copter when I really didn't need to. I still like doing that when they're tapped out. Now they can Reflector Mage me, but Reflector Mage isn't even that good, because Key to the City can cast this at instant speed. Put me at 7. Discard Spellqueller. Ugh, we drew the 4th Wilds. Man, it's bad. I guess we're just going to play the wilds. Probably can always sack his and Quagmire if I really want to. And Pryor holds off both of these from attacking, so I just go to 4. Can get their whole board. Pressure's Gideon better than playing an enthusiast. So yeah. Gonna play this. Not use key this turn. Or sorry, not you. I'm gonna play this and discard this to key, and then I can activate key. That's what we're actually doing here. Yeah, that's fine. Time I'll get a forest. And they only have two up, so I can go and afford to pay for key here. But I do play my land, I think. Play around Revolutionary Rebuff. And I'm going to sack this right now. I'm at four, so Smuggler's Copter can't kill me. Unless they have land, Thraben Inspector, Gideon Emblem. Which I could play around. So I probably should play around. If I attack for eight, they go to three. I have a bunch of Hissing Quagmires. So yeah, just to be safe, let's do this. See if they play Reflector Mage next turn. I can animate Quagmire. Could also play, sorry, could also play an Arborback Stomper. I don't know, maybe I should attack with all, though. It makes a pretty big difference because this makes unblockable. Reflector Mage. Balancing that. They only have one blocker, though. Except they have two blockers, I don't have lethal. Reflector Mage plus Thraben Inspector. I think I'm winning long game anyways. I'm just gonna make the conservative play. My opponent have to have a pretty specific hand. But I think this just ensures that I don't die. There's the Reflector Mage. And they can block one thing and then die from there. All right, so game three. I think our plan is fine here. Maybe I shave another orrery. Could bring in a sifter or two on the draw, just to have a few more ways to get to a fast pariah, because I think that's generally how I'm going to win. This card's also a lot worse on the draw. But you do want it for amalgams. But I don't really want to cut more keys or discard outlets, because then my deck just doesn't really function. So I could see bringing in two Catacomb Sifters and cutting a Scrounger. Then we still have seven ways to return these. And just bridging to five is nice. Play a little bit more of a fair game. I think I'm going to do that. Scrounger also just gets Reflector Mage on the draw, but doesn't really on the play. Well, this hand is really good with the discard outlet and medium otherwise, but I think I have enough discard outlets that I should keep. Like, there is some power here to be sure. The copter. I just keep drawing a million enthusiasts whenever I have some. I can just go turn three, turn four, turn five, though. It's not that bad. Interesting to play that before attacking. Probably not the right move, but because if they found an untapped land here, they could crack the clue this turn. Thalia probably indicates having a second Thalia, is my guess. Usually, when there's a key discard, that's what it means, or they have a bunch of expensive cards like Gideon and Avacyn, and Thalia just isn't as important as those. Well, we didn't get our discard plan, but you can see if I had drawn a Noose Constrictor or an Olivia's Dragoon or a Key to the City here, I could just discard Haunted Dead, and I could have discarded both prized amalgams and just gone off this game. So I haven't really shown the power of the deck, but you can see the potential. I just haven't drawn the right sort of pieces with the right cards. And that's alright. Getting to play Haunted Dead will make it so I can chump Gideon, though. Or trade with a Night Ally or anything like that. If I draw a black source, I can even return Haunted Dead, discard a Pariah, along with the prized Amalgam. That would bring back Unamalgam and also get Pariah into play. I mean, we're behind here, but it's not, definitely not the end of the world. Unfortunately, Pariah He's not going to eat an Avacyn here. Because Smuggler's Copter can be crude. Like a key to the city and a pariah. I guess Avacyn flipping. They'd have a 6-5 and a Gideon. I would go to 8, Gideon would put me down to 3. Pretty much dead to Reflector Mage if I take this line, and if their hand is Avacyn Reflector Mage, I'm gonna die. So we can make this unblockable and discard Pariah. Guess I could upkeep flip, but that's bad against Stasis Snare. But then Avacyn doesn't get to attack me if they don't have Stasis Snare. And I am pretty far behind, so I guess they get a lot of looks at Stasis Snare. Also, if they don't see the interaction of hitting Copter. The main problem is if I flip right now, I'm just gonna get. I have to. I guess I just block Avacyn and they have a Gideon. And I'm at 3. I'm at Gideon. Or. Sorry. They have Gideon. To me being at 3. Maybe that's just not that bad. I still lose to. But I still lose to Stasis Snare or Reflector Mage if I do this right now. So yeah, I might as well actually just wait. Do it on upkeep. It's much, much better that Avacyn can't attack this turn. And in case they do have Stasis Snare, I guess I keep Weaponcraft Enthusiast to chump. Yeah, this line seems much better to me. Now I don't have to trade this, then I can key in and attack Gideon. This also can chump Gideon. Yeah, this is just way, way, way better. An example of not playing scared. Please no Reflector Mage. Okay, that's unfortunate. We still haven't lost yet. So we block here. This happens. I go to 4. I am going to pay. Actually, am I going to pay? No, I need to chump both their creatures. So I need to play Weaponcraft and also discard these to Haunt the Dead. I'm not going to pay. I'm going to play this because it's more chump blockers. We do need to turn the corner pretty quickly because I'm running low on chances to be able to deal with Avacyn, so. Or to raise an Avacyn, rather. Might even be right to attack everything at my opponent. Not really sure. Ooh, that was a good one. So if I attack everyone at them and they use this EOT, I can flash this in. I guess I could even attack everything at Gideon. I can block one thing. If I attack just two things at Gideon, maybe they make a creature. So hold on, if we go attack Gideon, attack Gideon, attack Gideon, this forces them to use the Abbey. At which point then I can really get them. It'll just kill Gideon, my opponent will be at 20, but then we've stabilized at that point. Or they're just gonna let Gideon die. They have Spellqueller. Well, drawing Pry was very, very fortunate then. Otherwise I was dead, but now I'm way, way ahead. I could just sack these three. Actually, sorry, I should sack this, this, and this. Next turn I can discard the two cards I draw to bring back Amalgam and Haunted Dead and get another 1/1 flyer. And I should still have a two-turn clock. Well, that game was incredibly close, but you can see the power of Pry in this matchup. That's exactly why we have so many of them and why we have the Enthusiasts and everything else. Alright, that's match one.